While we are gathered to pay homage to the efforts of one of Ohio's great citizens, Mr. Warren Gard. Warren was the author in 1916, 100 years ago, of the Boy Scout National Charter. He was a man of great vision and foresight. He recognized, interestingly, the value of Boy Scouts at a very early time in the scouting program. It only started just 6 years earlier. He already saw what it should do, what it could do, and he knew what protections it needed, and he wrote the charter. He obtained unanimous approval for both houses of Congress. I don't think you can do that today, can you? It's hard to get any approval, much less unanimous approval. And he had it signed into law by President Woodrow Wilson on June the 15th, 1916. The Boy Scouts are the first organization ever to receive a charter from the U.S. government of any kind. We'd like to open this program with a flag ceremony conducted by selected Cub Scouts and Boy Scouts from the Fort Hamilton District of the Boy Scouts, and a call on Eagle Scout Kevin Watkins Lanick to come forward and lead us in the Scout flag ceremony.
Color Guard, advance. Color Guard, halt. Color Guard, prepare to post the colors. Color Guard, post the colors. Scout salute. Those not in uniform, please place your right hand over your heart. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Two. Color Guard, reform. Color Guard, return to post.
Good job, guys. Wonderful show. They came out here early and they practiced and they worked hard to get that one right, and I think they did. So a round of applause, please. You see here on the dais before you a number of distinguished speakers who will be giving you a lot more information on what Warren did, how he did it, why he did it, and the significance and the growth of the movement that he underwrote, the Boy Scouts. And I'm going to introduce each one of them shortly, but before I do, I'd like to first recognize some of the other distinguished guests we have with us today who've also come to honor this occasion. First is the Honorable Pat Moeller, Mayor of the City of Hamilton. Pat, you're right over here. Standing with him is Ann Antonin, former President of the Citizens for Historic Preservation Services, an architect, and the mayor of Hamilton, Ohio in 1978. So, Ann, thank you for being here today. Some of the members of Hamilton City Council may be in the audience. I'm not sure if I see them, but if you are, please consider yourself welcomed and acknowledged. Dale Holbrook, who grew up here, got a scouting start here, went on to become a National Scout Area Director, recently retired. Dale, you're here today. Thank you for being back. Dale was the first professional I worked with when I moved here, and we've stayed friends over the years. Irv Keyback, who is current chair of the Fort Hamilton District Boy Scouts. Irv, there you are, right over there. Thank you. The Fort Hamilton District, if you don't know, comprises almost all of the Scouts throughout Butler County. It's one of eight districts in the Dan Beard Council. Linda O'Connor was going to be here today. Linda, did you make it? Linda was working. She had two things to do. She's the president of the Lakota Board of Education, and she's the immediate past chair of the Fort Hamilton District, which under her leadership last year was recognized as being the top district in the Dan Beard Council 2015. So Linda, I don't see you, but please know that we thought about you and we'll talk to you later. Melissa Ford is our current district director, the professional that supports all the Scouts. And then a person that you will meet later, I don't see him in the audience right now because I think he's up in the office completing the setup of the Boy Scout historic display you'll see, is Larry Timmer. There you are. There you are. I didn't see when you came in. Larry, thank you in the red hat. Larry is our historian for the Fort Hamilton District, and he has developed a wonderful Boy Scout museum. It's actually portable. We've taken out to major camperies. No other districts have this. A lot of councils don't have this. And Larry's been doing a great job, and you'll see just some of the work he's done. You know, the iceberg, the 10% at the top, well, it's not even 10% of what you'll see up there, but it's still going to be interesting. And finally, David Chanteau. David, I know you're down here.
There he is.
There you are, right over there. Okay. David is the Greenwood Cemetery Director, where the marker is currently being installed today and enshrined. Now, if you don't already know it, this is going to be the first state historic marker ever installed in Greenwood Cemetery. So we get another first out of this. I'm going to start with the lady who made it happen, made it possible for us to be here today. It was her singular effort, this great lady, Miss Kathleen Fox, who was Warren Gard's great niece. She recognized the significance of her uncle's work all the way from 100 years ago. She conceived the idea of creating a permanent historic marker to memorialize the event, did all the groundwork, figured out who to talk to, contacted them all to make it happen. And in her wisdom, she selected the centennial anniversary year of the Boy Scout Charter to install the marker and bring it into being. She's going to tell you in her own words why she did this, what it means to her, and what it should mean to us. Please welcome Kathleen Fox to the podium.
Thank you. Is it on?
It's on.
Okay. Such a beautiful day today. I'm so happy that there's such a great crowd here to celebrate the life of my great uncle Warren Gard. I regret that my sister Neil Ann Stuckey Levine was not able to join me here. I never had the privilege of meeting Warren Gard, who died in 1929, but 2 years ago, when I started research on my mother's side of the family, an entire new world opened to me. Thus, I got to know Warren Gard personally. In my research, I discovered his great contributions to the Hamilton community and elsewhere. We are here to celebrate the 100th year of the signing of the Boy Scouts National Charter, which Warren Gard wrote in 1916. Congress passed the bill, H.R. 755, unanimously, and it was signed into law on June 15, 1916, by President Woodrow Wilson. And it was, The marker tells the story of Warren Gard as United States Congressman, judge, and lawyer from Hamilton, Ohio. I think of Uncle Warren and his wife, Pearl, every day, since I had the privilege of wearing the engagement ring that he gave to her when they were married on June the 22nd, 1910. My mother gave me this ring in 1973 as she was terminally ill with cancer. I also have around my neck a sterling, it's not working.
Just get it to your mouth.
Okay, hello? It's a carpenter's pencil in sterling silver with Warren Gard's initial on it, and you can see it later, but it's my sister gave it to me. Actually, when you think about it, history can be very emotionally overwhelming. Thank you for being here today.
I think when you talk to her, you'll find just how overwhelming this has been for her. Now, let me give you a little quick fact about Boy Scout history. 1911, 1 year after the start of Boy Scouting in America had begun, there were 61,495 boys in Scouting. 1 year, 60,000 people, boys, had gotten into Scouting. Now, just 5 years later, in 1916, when the Boy Scout Charter was signed, membership had quadrupled to 245,000 boys just in 5 years. Now, growth has been precipitous and it's been continuous, such that by the year 2000, want to guess, over 100 million boys, youth actually, now that we have girls in the program as well, have entered Boy Scouting, 100 million. and growth continues today. You know, I wonder if Warren had been able to conceive of what was going to come from all this, how big it was going to be, and how many people the program had blessed over the years. You know, that even if you do have great ideas, like today's historic marker being created, they don't just happen by themselves. It takes money, it takes organization to make that happen. And so, our next speaker is Dick Solomon, who is chair of the W.E. Smith Family Charitable Trust. He's going to tell us why he felt this event needed to occur and why he chose to make the money available. Please welcome Dick Solomon.
Just to correct the previous comment, I didn't make this possible. It wasn't my money, and I made a joint decision with our board. Thank you. I don't want to take any credit for having done that. The W.E. Smith Family Charitable Trust is a not-for-profit charitable organization organized exclusively for giving money to organizations and groups and school projects for the education of, promotion of, and communication of the history of our great country, and specifically what went into the building of the history, because W. Smith, who had been chair of Miami University's history department and the first director of the McGuffey Museum, was very keen on the fact that history of a nation is not top down. It's built from the bits and pieces of local stories being woven into the fabric of the history of the nation. And to that end, after his death, his wife and son decided they needed to make sure that his vast collection of historic documents and books and research papers were collected in one place to be preserved and to be used from that period forward. So in doing that, they created the Smith Library of Regional History, which is a equal but separate partner of the Lane Library and has been from the inception. And it's located in Oxford. The component of that which Mrs. Smith, and incidentally W. Smith and Mrs. Smith were both authors, together they wrote the definitive three-volume history of Southwestern Ohio, and she wrote several books about local history, and he wrote hundreds of monographs and papers and other books on various subjects in history, and was a frequent speaker as well throughout the country. The grant situation became a factor in all of this after the library was established and separate from the library operation, because Mrs. Smith saw the wisdom in helping local organizations and museums and schools have a little seed money to do projects, putting emphasis on the history of the local area and region. And so she would send money from her retirement home in California every year in modest amounts to the advisory board to administer these grants. And I put the emphasis on to the local organizations and regional organizations, because, as I said earlier, their theory was, and it's not simply a theory, but we are making the history of this nation. Each and every one of us in our involvements in the history of where we live. And another important emphasis, and one that is very important on this day, is encouraging, emphasizing, and promoting all of this activity among our youth, whether they're in the school, whether they're involved in a local historical organization, such as the young man that I had dinner with on Thursday at the Butler County Historical Society, who was the first ever, is he 12-year-old, Kathy? 11-year-old, to be named the Outstanding Volunteer of the Year for the Butler County Historical Society.
Wow.
And I say that especially to honor him, but also it is the involvement of the youth. And the Boy Scouts is the perfect example of what this money is intended to do. I think of everything. I was a Boy Scout. I think of everything that you all learn about citizenship, about being truly appreciative of what you have in a democracy. And it is so important that these be promoted to the world. And so we became involved in this historic marker program as well to provide for the viewing public, so to speak, in connection with the Ohio Historical Society, the snapshots of our local history. And there are many of these around the county and around the area. And you ought to, when you're anywhere else, stop and read them, both sides, because usually one side is dedicated to an idea, a concept, a group, some historic fact, the other side about the person or the individual who really promoted things then, which was Warren Gard in this case. So with that in mind, I want to thank all of the planners of this event, and I want to reemphasize the fact that the Smith Charitable Trust is so delighted that this one in particular has such heavy involvement on the importance of youth and learning history. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dick. Your point is well taken. The youth, it's not just the local youth. This is a national program, and it had major roots here. So I think your comments are right on target for that. Another little factoid for you, if you didn't already know it, the first Eagle Scout Award was made 2 years after the program started in 1912. It went to a young man named Arthur Rose Eldred. I'm not sure we'd name a boy Rose nowadays, but I bet he was tough, because he did a great job as a young man learning to be an Eagle Scout, the first one in the program. Now, hang on to that thought just for a second. Some of the giant names in scouting, the people who founded this program, were Lord Robert Baden Powell, Daniel Carter Beard, James E. West, Ernest Thompson Seton. Those of you in the scouting program know these names, know what they did, know the magnitude of their stature. Now, it might interest you to know that three of those, the latter three, personally sat in on Eldridge's Eagle Scout Board of Review to check him out. Robert Baden Powell would also have attended. He'd planned to, but he had a conflict and couldn't make it. Now, can you imagine how that 17-year-old young man must have felt with these giants hovering over him, verifying and validating his qualifications and achievements? I gotta believe he must never, ever have been bothered by pressure again any time in his life. But we've got a wonderful program that started there. That was the first one. There were 22 other Eagle Scouts that year. You might want to guess how many we've had since then. 2.5 million boys have earned their Eagle Scouts since Arthur Eldred, since Arthur Rose Eldred earned his back in 1912. Now let's continue on that point of history, and I'm going to talk about the Ohio History Connection. This is a nonprofit organization. It was incorporated in 1885. We know it more formally as the Ohio State Archaeological and Historical Society. Its mission is to promote a knowledge of archaeology and history in the state. And you know what? They're the ones who approve these applications for state historic markers. So that's one of the people that Kathleen had to go to get permission on this. And they looked over all the things that he had done and figured out how the chart, how the marker was going to be read. She's going to tell us the role that she had in her her name is Becky Trivison. She's a program coordinator at the Historical Society in Columbus. She's going to tell us the role that she and her organization played in approving the project and finalizing the choice of words. And I hope she tells us when she's up here, how do you take a man, a giant, with all these wonderful achievements in life and boil it down to a few words that still tell the story on one of these plaques? Becky, would you please talk to us?
Thank you, and thank you for having me here today. I will say that it is very difficult to take somebody who has had so much history and somebody who has done so many great things and take their life and bring everything down to about 130 words. It is an enormous task and one that takes quite a long time and sometimes a lot of back and forth between us and the local sponsor who has submitted the application, because it very much is a partnership between us and the sponsor who has submitted the application, because we still want the general spirit of the original text that was submitted to come through in the final marker. Our role is just to fact check and make sure that everything checks out and that all of the words, all of those 130 words on each side, will fit on the marker when we send it into production. But it is a very difficult task to get so much of somebody's life onto one or two sides of a marker. And I do have a factoid, a unknown giant in the Eagle Scouting world, Ken Trivison, who many of you probably do not know, my dad. My dad is a proud Eagle Scout, and while I was not a Boy Scout, I was a Girl Scout for many years. So I certainly do understand the importance of an organization like the Boy Scouts, and I look back on the years from the Girl Scouts with fond memories of all of the things that I did and the things that I learned and the friends that I made, with a lot of happiness and joy. And I'm really happy to be here today to be a part of this dedication because of that. And I'm also here today, as many of you are here today, because you love history, and I love history. And the marker that we're celebrating today really commemorates that. And it's really a true partnership between the Hamilton Community Foundation, the Greenwood Cemetery Association, and the W.E. Smith Family Charitable Trust. All of the people who wrote the text, did the research, raised the funds, submitted the application for this project. The markers program began at the Ohio History Connection in 1957, and it's a program that we're all very proud of. It's a very grassroots program. The community comes up with a topic and submits the application. It's really stories of the community about Ohio. And this program enables us to help Ohioans preserve and share their history in a very visible way that will last for many years. And there are now more than 1,500 historical markers up around the state or in production that reflect Ohio's unique history. And your marker honoring Warren Gard joins the other state markers that tell the story of Ohio. And you're to be commended for taking the initiative to identify such an important historical aspect of your community. And to mark the special event, I'm proud to present commendations from the Ohio History Connections Executive Director Bert Logan and the Board of Trustees to the Hamilton Community Foundation, to the Greenwood Cemetery Association, and the W.E. Smith Family Charitable Trust. So I'll read, it's a very short text that I'd like to just read here. The Ohio History Connection commends all of those partners who are named on each commendation for furthering the knowledge of our state's heritage by placing an Ohio historical marker on November 12, 2016 that commemorates, honors, and celebrates the legacy of Warren Gard and his service to the state of Ohio as a prosecuting attorney and judge and as a member of the U.S. House of Representatives, where he fought to repeal World War I wartime prohibition and to secure the passage of H.R. 755 to incorporate the Boy Scouts of America. And so I'd like to call up Dick Solomon, James Fitton of the Greenwood Cemetery Association, and if there's a representative of the Hamilton Community Trust, or Hamilton Community Foundation, excuse me, to come up to receive the commendations, I'd like to give those out. And thank you again for having me here today to share this day with you. It's a beautiful day. Please enjoy your marker and your place in history. And again, thank you for letting me share this day with you.
I'm also the Community Foundation Board, so I can take theirs as well.
Okay, thank you.
Congratulations.
I'll take both of those.
Oh, okay.
I can do both.
Thank you.
Thank you, Becky. Thank you very much. You know, if a Boy Scout attends his weekly patrol and troop meetings, he participates in a monthly weekend troop outing, usually camping, but sometimes something else. If he goes to long-term summer camp with his troop, in 1 year, he will have spent as much time in scouting as he spends in the classroom. Another education, another significant part of a young man's education. Warren Gard must have seen the value of this time for boys in scouting when he wrote the Boy Scout Charter, and State Senator Bill Coley has graciously offered to give us an insight into Warren's thinking by reading aloud some of Warren's actual words selected from the charter. So please welcome Senator Bill Coley from Ohio District 4 as he gives us this look into Warren's mind.
Thank you. And Bob, let me say, to answer the question of whether you can get something through unanimously through the legislature, but it takes something like the Boy Scouts to bring people together like that, and it would still work today. These great organizations, the thing we love about scouting is it's not the competition amongst boys, it's each boy competing with himself, each boy striving to live the Scout oath and the Scout law. And that's why we love scouting so much. And even after it had just been formed, 100 years ago, Warren summarized it best in the preamble that he wrote to this piece of legislation. And the preamble states that the Boy Scouts have not only demonstrated their worth to the nation, but have also materially contributed to a deeper appreciation by the American people of the higher conception of patriotism and good citizenship. Every nation depends for its future upon the proper training and development of its youth. The American boy must have the best training and discipline of our great democracy can provide if America is to maintain her ideals, her standards, and her influence in the world. Anything that is done to increase the effectiveness of the Boy Scouts of America will be a genuine contribution to the welfare of the nation. I don't think you can say it better than that, and it was just so eloquent and so accurate. And for that reason, I am so glad we're here today to honor this work. And we had a flag flown over the U.S. Capitol in honor of this event, and we also have a congratulations and accommodation from the Ohio Senate with the thanks of Senate President Keith Faber and the entire Ohio Senate. We congratulate everyone on their involvement in this project, and it'll serve as a monument for many, many centuries to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill. We talked about scouts. Let's talk about scouting volunteers. 1.2 million volunteers in the country today working with scouts. They donate an average of about 20 hours a month to the program. That adds up to about 208 million hours of time in just 1 year. Now, there's a group called the Independent Sector, which projects the average value of this volunteer time to be $20 an hour. Okay, well, I think I'm worth more than that, but that's all right. I'll take the $20. But if you take that and multiply it by the number of hours every year, the approximate value of the time given by Boy Scout volunteers is worth more than $5.8 billion, with a B, dollars annually to this country. And that doesn't include the extra time, the extra service, the extra value of service projects conducted by scouts in the community. Just last year, here in Fort Hamilton District alone, our Boy Scouts and our crews, our venturing crew scouts, contributed 56,000 hours of service to the community. So it's an investment that gets great dividends back into the community. Now, our next speaker is Edgar Smith. Edgar is president-elect of the Danbury Council Boy Scout. He's actually going to be sworn into office 3 days from now, but he didn't get here overnight. He spent many years both as a scout and then as a scout leader, and now in scout major leadership. And he's going to give us his insight into why this charter was and is so important to scouting, and what scouting has achieved as a result of the protections and the opportunities that it offers. Please welcome Edgar Smith.
Thank you. Can you hear me? Thank you, Bob. Before I get started, I just want to say good afternoon, but what a beautiful day to have this Charter Centennial celebration. As Bob started his comments as our Master of Ceremonies today, and he looked out into the audience at many of you and called you out and recognized you, it just reminded me about scouting in the sense that scouting brings together people that might not otherwise come together to do great things. One of the things that I've learned in my years on this planet is that we don't do it by ourselves. We do it with and through others. So I want to applaud each and every one of you for what you've done, your being here today. I also want to thank the people that have come before me on this platform for their meaningful words and their actions as it relates to scouting. Again, good afternoon. I'm Edgar Smith, and I'm the Council President-elect for the Danbury Council Boy Scouts of America. And on behalf of our board and leadership and over 30,000 youth and hundreds of Cub Scout packs, Boy Scout troops, venturing crews, varsity teams, Explorer Post, and Learning for Life groups located in 12 counties in southwestern Ohio and northern Kentucky, I am pleased to be able to present to represent the Danbury Council and the Boy Scouts of America at this historic marker dedication celebrating the 100th anniversary of the BSA Charter. Over the last few years, we've had an opportunity, and we've been very fortunate, to celebrate several centennials. The Boy Scouts of America itself in 2010, the first Eagle Scout in 2012, and the Danbury Council, the establishment of the Danbury Council in 2013. You know, as a youth growing up in the Detroit metropolitan area, I was a Cub Scout, a Weeblo, a Boy Scout, and I achieved the rank of Eagle in 1978, the same time frame that Ann was mayor of Hamilton. And I finished up with 54 merit badges and two silver palms. Scouting helped develop my life. It prepared me to interact with my community, to explore, and to build on my dreams. I truly credit scouting with being a strong contributor to my life today, as a business and community leader. This historic marker is being dedicated at the gravesite here at the Greenwood Cemetery of local Congressman Warren Gard, who authored the Congressional BSA Charter 100 years ago. You've heard a lot about this man. I'm going to just say a few more words about him because he is a very impressive person. Warren Gard was an absolute leader. He was one of the most prominent men in Butler County in the early 20th century. He was born and raised here in Hamilton, Ohio. He was the son of S.Z. Gard and Mary Duke, and the brother of Homer Gard, the owner and publisher of the Hamilton Journal News for over 50 years. Besides being a United States Congressman, William Gard was also a lawyer and a judge in Hamilton for many years. And this beautiful centennial celebration is especially poignant since the Ohio Historic Marker is being dedicated again 100 years after Gard helped to introduce one of the most important things that he would do as a congressman, which was to secure the passage of Bill H.R. 755, this giving the Boy Scouts of America their national charter. The bill, as you heard, passed unanimously in the House, and President Woodrow Wilson signed it into law on June 15, 1916, thus granting federal incorporation to the Boy Scouts of America. I will say, dear God, thank you for Warren's love of the Boy Scouts and his help in sponsoring this important bill. According to the National Center for Charitable Statistics, more than 1.5 million nonprofit organizations are registered in the United States. Congress grants charters to organizations with a patriotic, charitable, historical, or educational purpose. There are currently 93 nonprofit organizations that hold a congressional charter. 93. The Boy Scouts are one of 93. For nearly 100 years, the Boy Scouts have created a strong foundation of leadership, service, and community. For millions of America's young people, specifically, the movement is comprised of over 2.7 million young people between the ages of 7 and 20, and over a million volunteers in more than 272 councils throughout the United States and its territories. Today, the Boy Scouts of America is one of the nation's largest and most prominent value-based youth development organizations. You know, one of the things that my mother talked to me about as I was growing up as a young man in Detroit was values. She was an educator. She taught in the Detroit public school system for over 40 years. And one of the things that we would talk about weekly was values. Values are very important. Again, we are a value-based youth development organization, and that I'm very proud of. The BSA provides a program for young people that builds character, trains them in responsibilities of participating leadership, and develops personal fitness. We have certainly put our charter to productive use, as we have been very busy over the last 100 years developing youth to be prepared for life. I would like to say thank you to Mr. Warren Gard. God bless you, and God bless the Boy Scouts of America. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oops. Well, this brings us to that magic moment we've been waiting for. So it took us a long time to get here, and you've been very patient. I really want to point out the patience of two young men standing behind me who've been serving as an honor guard at attention the whole time on the flags. We're going to put them to work right now because this is when we're going to do the unveiling of the State Historic Marker honoring Warren Gard and the Boy Scout Charter. The unveiling will be done by Kathleen Fox and our two Eagle Scouts, who are Kevin Watkins Lanick from Troop 956 and his friend Aaron Race from Troop 926. So if you just all please give them your attention as they gather at the base of the marker. How about that? It's a beautiful piece. It's been well done. We appreciate your efforts in making all this happen, too, so thank you very much. We've got special commendations to be read from the State House and State Senate in Columbus and the presentation of a flag flown in special honor of this occasion that was flown over the National Capitol. And our presenters will be State Representative Mark A. Condit from District 52 and State Senator Bill Coley from District 4. So which one of you all would like to go first? All right.
Thank you so much for letting us share this day with you. You know, I'm the mother of an Eagle Scout, and so I'm grateful to Congressman Warren Gard for his role in chartering the Boy Scouts of America. And as a legislator, I'm impressed, because if he got this done unanimously in both houses, he's my hero. And as an American, I'm eternally grateful to Congressman Warren Gard for creating this organization that teaches character and virtues and builds up our future citizens. Kathleen, on behalf of the 131st General Assembly of the Ohio House of Representatives, I'd like to present you this award for your Uncle Warren and recognize him posthumously and salute the memory of him as a truly honorable man. Congratulations on your uncle.
Thank you. Thank you.
Here, turn this back.
There you go. Okay. Show the crowd.
That's okay. Okay. And Kathleen, on behalf of Ohio Senate President Keith Faber and the entire Senate, we echo that and present you the same commendation, and I'll deliver that to you.
Okay. All right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
This does the ceremony as far as the marker is concerned. We do have one more short ceremony we'd like to have. It's one a little more personal for Warren's family. We'd like to conduct a short wreath-laying ceremony at Warren Gard's grave, which is behind you over here underneath the green tent. And Kathleen Fox and our two Eagle Scouts will conduct that ceremony with a wreath that she made herself by hand from materials she found here in the cemetery this week. So this is from the heart to the heart. So would you please join us now over at the gravesite for our final ceremony. Who from the cemetery, who is also the president of the Greenwood Cemetery Association. And then one of the reasons he's here is he's Kathleen's cousin. I told you this is a family event. So if you will do the wreath laying ceremony now, we appreciate that.
All right.
And we'll notice that the grave sites have been cleaned, and they're so beautiful. All the Gard family is here, and my godmother Ethelene Gard Graham is over here, and Camel Gard, who's named after Camp Camel Gard, he's here, and my Aunt Pearl, I mean right here, whose ring I have on my finger, engagement ring. I'm overwhelmed. And I'm thanking everyone for coming. And I couldn't find a wreath to buy because they don't have them yet. So I begged the people here to cut the trees down so I can make this beautiful wreath. And they were so happy to let me have the pine needles. I'm putting this wreath on Warren's grave, duplicating what my mother did in February of 1958, when she represented the Gard family and laid the wreath at the cemetery with the Boy Scouts of America and a group similar to this in this same position here. Now, the Ohio Historical Marker has permanently etched this occasion in bronze for all to learn about Warren's contributions to Hamilton and beyond. And there's a picture when we go to this 1602 Greenwood Avenue, where there'll be a reception. There's a picture of my mother at the grave site with her mink stole on in 1958 for everybody to look at. And thank you so much for coming today. I'm really overwhelmed. Thank you so much.
My final duty is to get off stage, and I'm going to do that by turning it over to Jim Fitton, who is going to do the closing remarks for today. Jim?
Great. Thanks, Bob. Again, to compliment Kathleen for getting this done today. It is truly an historic moment here at Greenwood Cemetery, which we're blessed to have many historic moments here at the cemetery. But Kathleen, again, thanks for all your work and your efforts. The Boy Scouts of America, thanks again for being here. It's just been a beautiful day. Turned out to be a great day weather-wise. No snow, no rain, no curses, no anything. So it's all good stuff here today. The Board of Trustees of Greenwood, again, is very proud of Warren Gard and the things that occurred here today. It is a garden of memories. As you drive through the cemetery to go over to the offices on Greenwood, please take a moment to observe some of the beautiful monuments and markers that you see in this cemetery. It is truly an historical cemetery. And we're fortunate to be remembering Congressman Warren Gard, but there are so many other very important people, not only to the city of Hamilton, but to Butler County, that are housed here permanently. And again, I encourage you to walk around and maybe, from a historical standpoint, get to know some of the folks that are here. As has been said before, there are refreshments. There's a great presentation of the history of the Boy Scouts and the Greenwood Cemetery offices. It's very easy. Go that way.
Just follow the card.
Yeah.
To 1602 Greenwood Avenue.
Yeah. Larry Timmer did a great job setting that up. I visited it earlier today. I think everybody would be very impressed of the history of the Boy Scouts of America here in the Fort Hamilton District. And again, thanks everybody for being here. Let's get out of the cold, go in and get some refreshments and some goodies, and let's go have a good day. Thank you very much for being here.